In this video, I'm talking about empathy, the intellectual aspects and the emotional aspects. Empathy is a tool to socialize, to connect to other people at intellectual and emotional level. And you can think about empathy as a self-development, and some people stuck, even when they are adults, stuck at a very early development phase, and other people become much more mature and understand other people's feeling much better. So the cognitive element, it can be absolute zero, that you have no idea what's going on other people, you don't even think about this, and in an extreme case this is autistic person. If you have autism, if you have no idea, don't even think about other people, you don't even register that other people have emotion. And then there is the next level of empathy, is that you can relate to them because you experience that, okay, if I would lose my money or my job, I would be very sad. So at this early stage of empathy is that, how would you feel in that person's situation when that thing happens to you? The next level of empathy is that, how do you think this person feels? Not because you, how would you feel, but you understand this person's special circumstances. So let's say that if you are a beautiful woman who can find a partner very easily, then when you break up with somebody, then it's not a big deal, you can very easily find something, somebody. But let's say if you're not a very attractive woman, then it's very difficult to find a great partner again. So if you understand, let's say if I'm a beautiful woman and my friend who is a not very attractive woman loses, so the first level of empathy was that, oh, if I lose my friend, it's not a big deal, so why are you crying? So what's the point? That it's very easy to find a guy. So you don't really understand that this person doesn't experience the same thing as you because you have a special circumstances. So this level of empathy, that you can put yourself into the other person's shoes, the specific. So not how would you feel in that person's situation, but how that person feels in her or his special circumstances, because it can be very, very difficult. So this is a higher level. So the previous level was that you can model that if somebody loses the job, then the person probably feels very bad because I would feel bad. So this is, you are using your mental model relating to another person. But if you can put yourself into the other person's shoes, you can have a meta model, which is modeling the other person's mental model about life and understanding that person's situation through their thinking and values and skills and how they relate. So this is a higher level, using meta modeling, putting yourself into the other person's shoes, not in your shoes if it happens to you. Okay, so at a cognitive level you can go higher and higher level, understanding this person's special situation. Now, and then there is the emotional aspect of empathy, when you can feel in certain degree the same feeling as other people. So just because you feel cognitively, it doesn't mean that you can feel the same feeling of other people. And when you have absolute no emotional connection to other people's suffering, then sometimes there are using some names like as a disease or disorder, like psychopath, sociopath. It means that Psychopath doesn't feel other people's feeling, maybe even if they feel very happy. Cognitively, they understand this person's situation, but emotionally not. And so that's why they have huge power, because they can control, they can exploit these people. So psychopaths, they're just like normal people. But emotionally, they cannot connect to these people, and they don't feel bad when other people feel bad. And sociopaths, and also psychopaths, they can also enjoy other people's suffering. So it can be so bad. A sociopath can connect in some degree to one or maybe two special person, but generally speaking, not. Okay, so but some people of the society is like this, but most people have some emotional affiliation to other people. So when other people feel good, then they feel some way good. If the other people feel bad, they also can feel bad. And it is through mirror neurons. Mirror neurons is some specialized neurons that you can feel other people's feeling. So think about this, that the brain has billions and trillions of neurons that connect it to each other and communicate very strongly. But other people's are also connected to your brain neurons, not directly. So inside the brain, the neurons connect through synapses. They are not touched to each other. There is a gap between them, and there is chemical communication between its mirror transmitters. It's kind of hormone in the brain. So chemically, the neurons communicate with each other. But we humans are also connected with each other. So the 8 billion people as a huge neural network connected with not chemicals, but communication and intellect and thinking. So mirror neurons are neurons in your mind that are activated and have a similar, not so strong, feeling as other people. So when other people, when other person cuts a finger and start to bleed, usually the mirror neuron sends a pain signal into your mind, and it's not a direct, of course, not direct connection, but you see it, you process the information, and it has an emotional aspect. And some people are very strongly influenced by other people's happiness and pain, and they can feel physically in their own bodies. And other people, maybe their mirror neurons are not so many and they are not so sensitive. So there is an emotional aspect of empathy when you can feel it. And it's not the same as sympathy. Sympathy is, you poor things, I feel sorry. It's more about pretending outwards, and maybe inwards you feel nothing, and even feel happy that, hey, I am better than this one. So it can be an ego. So it can be the opposite of the ego, because the ego maybe feels happy when other people suffer, because I'm relatively better than other people. And maybe you feel envy when you think that other people are better than you. So envy is kind of opposite of the empathy. So empathy, the emotional aspect through the mirror neurons, that you have similar feelings. And when you feel envy, it is about that other people are successful, but you feel bad. So it's kind of opposite. So, and we all have this combination, and other people are much more tuned in to move in the same direction as other people feel. So they can feel the same. The mirror neuron aspects of their mind is much more stronger, and other people, or in other situation, we have envy when we go to the opposite, when other people suffer, and you see, you didn't listen to me. You I'm so happy. It's not about talking to the other person, but it's the inner dialogue, what we say about this, that when you feel good when other people suffer, because maybe they hurt you in the past, or they were successful and you were envy, and then you have this opposite feeling. So we have a kind of emotional connection to other people. Maybe it's the same direction, maybe not, maybe no any feelings. And it, of course, it depends on a lot of specific situation. Who's the other person? What is your mood? What is your state? Because we also go through different stages, states, emotional and physical states. So we have a different resonance with other people, because it's not about just the other person, it's about a relationship. So empathy is a relationship, is how at this moment I can relate to your pain or happiness. So it's not about just I'm always fixed, and in any situation, any of my situation, I can empathize with other people exactly the same. No, it is a relationship. Empathy is a relationship, that there is the other person's situation and there is your situation. Because if you are suffering, if you feel, if you focus on yourself, you cannot empathize so well with other people. When you are in a very healthy physical situation, mentally everything is okay in your life, then probably you can tune in to other person's frequency in a much more effective way. But when you focus on yourself, because you have physical pain, you have emotional pain, you have your own problem in your life, probably you are not so open to other people's situation. So empathy is a relationship, yourself and other person, in a cognitive way, how much logically you can understand other person's specific situation, and in an emotional way, how much you can connect.